Welcome back to Radio Entrepreneurs. We're on the air. My name is Jeffrey Davis. And our next guest, I'm going to rush right into it, and an inspiring guest. Raun, is it Raun?
Yeah, it is.
Raun Kaufman, author and former CEO of the Autism Treatment Center of America. Center or centers?
Center.
Center of America. And I guess we should start with your story, correct?
Sure. Yeah, I mean, at a young age, I was diagnosed with a very severe case of autism. So I had no language, no communication. I spent my time rocking back and forth, flapping my hands in front of my face, which is common to a lot of kids on the spectrum. I would take kitchen plates and spin them on their edge on the floor over and over again for hours and hours. And my parents were told that this is a permanent lifelong condition, that I had an IQ of less than 30. And when I got a little older, I'd need to be put in an institution where I'd spend the rest of my life. And they really did something amazing in the face of that, which is they developed their own home-based, very much child-centered program where they worked with me for about 3.5 years. And at the end of that period, as you can tell, I recovered completely without any trace of my former condition, graduated from Brown University, lived a totally normal life. And, you know, for me, I feel really privileged because I'm still with the Autism Treatment Center of America, and
what's
we get to
the basis of the treatment? Because it's a major breakthrough.
Yeah,
really get through. Because you're, look, I don't know you. I don't know about Brown's acceptance ratio or graduating averages.
Yeah.
I'll make fun of them. That's not my alumni. But yeah, you're clearly a very alert person.
I'd like to think so. Yeah. And to answer your question in terms of what helped me, that's what we do with the Autism Treatment Center of America. So this was originally developed by my parents. It's called the Sunrise Program,
right.
But they spelled it S-O-N-R-I-S because I was their son, right?
I got it.
And it's actually, if you take all the dominant paradigm in helping children with autism and you do essentially the exact opposite, you get the Sunrise Program. So what we actually do is, normally when children with autism are helped, the idea is you want to stamp out the unwanted behavior and promote the wanted behaviors. It's treated like a behavioral thing. But autism is not a behavioral disorder. It's a social relational challenge. These kids have difficulty connecting and communicating with other people. So that means that rather than forcing these children to conform to a world that they don't yet understand, we start by joining them in their world first.
So do you still get a lot of negative feedback from psychologists? Are there someone who say this was a once in a million situation or...
Well, it was certainly any possible objection you can imagine we've gotten. The once in a million thing's a funny thing to say, though, which I do still hear sometimes, because it doesn't really – that's my experience, which is my recovery. But for the last 30-plus years since the Autism Treatment Center of America has been in existence, we've worked with tens of thousands of kids from over 100 different countries. So there's been kids after me that have recovered – also, and there's kids that haven't recovered but have made incredible progress.
I no cure is 100%.
Yeah.
Now, do you remember being autistic at all?
I don't have like a day-to-day of like, oh, this is why I spun plates or this is why I did this. I remember little bits. Like I remember things, and this might sound crazy, but things looked and sounded really different. So if I looked at someone's face, sometimes it would look like I was looking through the wrong end of a pair of binoculars.
Who started the treatment centers after your development? Your parents?
Originally, yeah. It was started by my parents, who still actively teach at the Autism Treatment Center of America.
Were they educators for a living?
They were teachers and authors, but they were not at all before this in the field of autism, which is a really good thing.
Right.
This is a key thing. If you want to, this is not just true for autism, but it's true for anything, right? If you really want to solve a problem, and especially a so-called unsolvable problem, and affect change, you have to come from outside the field.
They made a movie about you, right?
They did.
Right.
Actually, first my
they
father
found someone
wrote,
good looking to do, play you.
They
right?
did, thankfully. I'm so grateful for that. Actually, by the way, we were just talking about this. It was a pair of twins.
And they was NBC, not your parents.
right, exactly.
So tell us
my
about
parents
the movie.
Wrote the screenplay. Well, here's what happened. So my father actually is an author. He's written about 14 books. And his first book was actually called Sunrise, spelled S-O-N-R-I-S-E. And it was updated to Sunrise, The Miracle Continues. But it became a bestseller. And then NBC picked it up and they wanted to make a movie about it, which they did. And this came out in 1979, 1980. And it was seen by actually over hundreds of millions of people in the U.S. and Europe. And it was
and
all
Canada.
About... And Canada, yes. Yeah. And people...
You can't watch Canadian TV in Canada. You have to have cable.
Of course. You know, you have to have full American colonization
Absolutely.
Of the world.
Yes.
So basically, yeah, this movie came out and people started to... It was a really inspiring story. And people started to come to us for help. And that's why in 1983... we founded the Autism Treatment Center of America, and it's a nonprofit charitable organization. We have money donated every year. We gave away $1.7 million just last year alone in financial aid to families.
That's just on an annual basis.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Yeah. So, and you know, if you have a child with autism, holy cow, I don't care who you are, you're facing serious financial challenges.